Jonathan, I'm so horny. Sex? In retreat. Coitus interruptus. No, of course not. Cunnilingus? Fellatio? No. Into nature, away from. And welcome to the Matrixers, with the wonderful Jonathan N. The beautiful Shiva. Here we are again, with an exciting topic. I may have already seen the cover photo. Sounds lurid, but it isn't. Because if what we and many others have also noticed, who have written to us, then it is not sensational, but the truth. Yes, as many may have already noticed, dissociation shows us a completely different world than we are used to from everyday life. And the world of dissociation has entered, as the word suggests, with the help of dissociation. It's not that easy to achieve now, but as always, practice makes perfect. And over time, a whole different world opens up to you. I wouldn't say that it's a new world, rather it's a world that opens up, that just wraps around everyday life. Integrated, so to speak. The original world, so rather, it depicts the condition, the more original condition than the one we have here in the everyday world. Yes, world that is seen there is more original and is also more based on the knowledge that we all live in a virtual reality. And in this virtual reality, as you can imagine, an environment has to be set up. And this constructed environment must, of course, also be filled with people who represent the environment realistically. Exactly, because what we want to describe now is aimed at precisely that. You don't have to be in the complete state of dissociation for this. A slightly dissociative state is enough to be able to perceive it. So you don't have to have dissociated for 10 minutes to see what we saw or many others. But where you just calm your thoughts and go into a slight dissociation, you can do this computer simulation that we have here, already. Perceive with all their figures in it. Yes, and you know that too, maybe from some films or series. Example, of course, the classic example. Matrix. Dot. The classic example here is Star Trek. Oh well, okay. Star Trek? Yes. Ah, yes of course. Or Matrix. Exactly. With the holodeck and Mr. Smith. So. Okay. So the holodeck is a room that you can enter. And then you can tell the computer, hey, I'd like to have a Parisian cafe and I'd like to have a coffee there. And then the computer creates everything. The cafe, the tables, chairs, waiters, guests, everything is there. Set up within a second at the speed of light. You can also touch the waiter and waitress if you want. So you don't get through. These are holograms that also have a certain density, so that when you touch them, you have the impression of touching a normal person. And of course that's what makes the holodeck so attractive for the entire crew of the Starship Enterprise. And they always have to put themselves on a list. Tonight at 6 p.m. I want to go to the holodeck for an hour, and then you can program everything. You can program a beautiful beach in Costa Rica or something, or Brazil. Or somehow everything is programmable there. And of course all the extras are part of the computer simulation. What is exciting is that there is actually only one real actor and everything else is extras. Yes, that's very interesting. And if you were to imagine that there might be a kind of special program on this holodeck, that is, you enter the holodeck, program the holodeck, you then have your Paris cafe and then you would be able to temporarily erase your memory. So you wouldn't remember entering the holodeck. You wouldn't remember where the exit is from the holodeck. And you wouldn't even remember that you created this whole environment yourself. That has been programmed like this before. Including figures. You think they're all... Then what would you think if you were on the holodeck? Well, you would then really believe all of them are real. This is my reality. Yes, we believe that here too. Correct. We're on a gigantic holodeck. Holodeck Earth. Also a simulation. And creepy. Yeah, right. And that's the exciting thing about it. And in dissociation you see things like that. That's when you start to remember. Slowly. Bit by bit. Drop by drop. You suddenly begin to remember. And that includes the perception of extras. You suddenly notice people around you, where you suddenly have the feeling, man, there's no one in there and they don't seem real at all. Or how did you experience that in the dissociation? I've done that more often lately, especially with the focus on the extras. And they all know exactly what they are doing, and they can also be taken over, these extras. Sometimes that happens too. And then you feel it too. And you get the feeling they're peering at you, that you're being watched. But not because you're particularly great or anything, but just, remember, I described it to you the other day on the escalator. This feeling of why they're doing it, this intention behind it, this not necessarily malicious, but that was a very specific feeling and I can't even describe it properly anymore. That they look at you on purpose. That you notice that and unfortunately I don't know what to do anymore. It is a, I know the feeling, of course, but unfortunately I can't describe it anymore. Well, it's very strange and you also have the feeling that these extras are taken over from time to time by aliens from outside and then they play their game with you. And you also notice very clearly that I don't have to lift my cup or laugh or have no idea that they do everything in precise agreement. And that it is a huge play. In this dissociation or in the dissociative state, the whole stage around it becomes aware that it is all a stage and that everyone is playing their role and every detail has been agreed, who is doing what and when. I mean, it's kind of logistical, because I can't quite understand how they do it alone in a mall. But it works, they do. And I've seen it often enough now that this is the case. I also find it interesting that when I dissociate, for example, I perceive exactly that myself. Yes, and I've also talked to other people who are familiar with dissociation, with people who suffer from it, for example, which means that dissociative states occur quite automatically in them and they can't explain why. Suddenly it appears and they have the same perceptions. So one cannot speak of a hallucination here, of an individual one. No, a lot of people have already written that and that they perceive it in a similar way. And if a lot of people in the same state perceive it the same way, there must be something to it. Yes. And it was the same with me. For example, when I was in the dissociative state and I was standing somewhere on the street or went for a walk somewhere and then observed the other people, I then noticed that they were suddenly me. Seemed very conscious, so that I could literally hear their thoughts. Yes, in that direction, yes, And then they thought things like, yes, I'll pretend to be an old grandmother who has to walk along here very slowly with her cane. Exactly. And at that moment I naturally asked myself, is that an old grandma then? When she knows full well that at the moment she is only pretending to be an old grandma who can hardly walk. Or children who played. Then I heard their thoughts. Let's pretend we're kids playing with each other. And that's with every person I've focused on. Then, so to speak, in his mind it sounded like they were really doing what they were doing at that moment on purpose. They acted like they were who they were portraying. And of course we asked ourselves the question, yes, in the dissociative state, don't you simply perceive it as it really is? Do we perceive all the souls? Basically, we are all actors. We have a conscious actor behind us, so to speak, who steers us here like marionettes, whatever. Of course we asked ourselves, yes, do we simply perceive the original condition or is there really no one there? And once in the dissociative state recently, I then noticed that there was only one more point of light here. One. I don't know if that's true, I just perceived it that way. Sometimes you still like to doubt, but the dear mind, whatever. Yes, in any case it really seemed as if everything were really just holograms. There is no one in there, they can be taken over, or then hosts, as you also wrote in your article on Matrix blog. Yeah, but everything else is blank. There's nothing in there, empty. And considering we're like 400,000 here are in this city. Right where we are, you mean? You mean where we are right now, and since there are three light bulbs, that's a bit small. And then you can already assume that the number is 99% correct. The Aborigines have already said that there are actually only 144,000 there are real people here on this planet. In the meantime, the number may be somewhere else. More and more starseeds are incarnating and they are helping to overthrow this system from inside and outside. Yes, but still seen from a total of 8 billion people, a very high percentage and a very high percentage really seems to be vacant. Yes. And because of our perception in dissociation or in dissociative states, we have then been able to identify two main categories of extras, namely the hosts and the sharers. And the hosts, as Shiva already said, are the extras who are supposed to fill the scenery. And of course everyone seems to be pretty aware. So they know what they're doing and they know exactly why they're doing it. And they do it the way they do it on purpose. Sometimes you get the feeling they want to tease you by looking at you. I do not know either. Then there are the so-called sharers. The sharers are quite rare. It's just the personalities, the souls that take over a body here, so to speak, and then live in this body for the rest of their lives. Yes, like both of us. We are sharers, meaning we connected to our body from outside the matrix, and are now inside the matrix with amnesia, meaning we don't remember the exit. Like here with the holodeck analogy. If you want to exit the holodeck, the person who was on the holodeck always has to shout, computer, and then an exit appeared and you could exit the holodeck. We've tried it often enough. Did not work. That was. And. Yes. And if you don't know this magic word, let me say, computer on the holodeck and don't remember that you can use it, then the situation is that the exit will never appear. And well, then you just stay on the holodeck, until the power goes out again. Yes, I mean, the generators are slowly deteriorating, but it will still take a few thousand more years until this is also here. But yes, yes and? Or someone will tell you when you meet someone. But that's quite unlikely because the sharers are all the ones who are there with amnesia and the hosts won't tell you because the hosts have an interest in you watching their show. Yes. And they are also programmed by the system, which means that they support the system and not necessarily what you would like. But I find it interesting that there is an intention behind it, that the people, the real ones now, are already developing a bit. Because it's just in the nature of a human being, a creator being, curiosity, development, no idea. And in such a way that curiosity is just satisfied, but not enough to see the exit or find the way out. So all the new age systems, all the techniques, practices, gurus and I know what were all invented and presented to us so that we can be distracted, so that we can satisfy ourselves a little bit, but not to be able to really go deep into the matter. This really only creates dissociation, among other things, because it's not a technique. This is actually our condition in the original, silence, emptiness. Dot. And that's why I recommend again Jonathan's book, Spiritual Dissociation, and I'm full of advertising. In any case, it's really recommended, because that's really the master technique in order to actually be able to aim for the exit from the matrix without distracting yourself with any new age hocus pocus, developing a bit, falling back again. And yes, all made up nonsense. That's what the elite does, the deep state, the deep, deep state, and should you keep your hands off only where you have a heartfelt feeling, yes, that's definitely a path I can, may, should, too. Really develop myself. So, end of advertising, on we go. You notice in the dissociation that it is important to the extras, the hosts, that you watch them, that you integrate into the environment and also identify with the role-playing game that they are delivering. So the hosts, as Shiva says, can also sometimes be taken over. We don't yet know 100% who will take over, so now in particular. But we assume that it is the Matrix architects who have their people there who then take over the hosts in special cases. And that's where I noticed, for example, a category of hosts that can be taken over. This is done by so-called guards. And these guardians have only one job, and that is to actively monitor people who are in a dissociative state to see if they are in their immediate environment, and then make sure to bring that person. Out of the dissociative state, because yes could then shake up this whole camouflage system. Because if, for example, millions of people would perceive what the few people perceive within this dissociative state, then there would be a lot going on in the world here. And that's why there are so-called guards. I met a guard myself can watch. And yes, I have to say, he apparently sensed that I was in that condition. But since I was in a cafe, he knew, or at least I could telepathically pick it up, he didn't know which of the people in the cafe were in such a state. And he was constantly looking around and looking for it, looked at who was behaving conspicuously and many people who stumbled into dissociation, I would say, they are all behaving conspicuously. They say, what's going on here? Or what do I know what they do or then behave very, yes, abnormally. At the moment, not like all the others, and then of course they quickly stand out in the crowd. And I didn't do that at the moment. I stayed completely calm and cool, kept pretending to be a regular cafe goer, and when the guard looked elsewhere again, I watched him and tried to telepathically scan him to get just as much information about this guardian. And yes, I have that, as Shiva says, in matrixblogger.de. Also wrote an article about it, and we thought that we should make a video about it. To the hosts and the sharers and the guards, of course. Guardians are also a bit like the Matrix. Yes, absolutely. You could also see that all the people running around there could also be taken over by agents to hunt down Neo, because Neo just behaved abnormally in quotation marks, because he was really good at fighting. Yes, he could even fly. And those in the Matrix didn't find that so funny when someone was flying around like Superman or something. And that would be the same in our reality. Imagine if someone appeared here who could walk on water or who could levitate or fly. Yeah, think about what's going on here. They hunt him to the death. Yes, absolutely. I also find it interesting that if you try to dissociate or try to get into a dissociative state, the Matrix goes completely nuts. Suddenly the waiter comes. Yes, and it didn't come hours before. Something always happens, or somehow I don't know. Everything possible then happens, which in any case hadn't happened for hours before, in order not to leave you in this dissociative state. Yeah, so if you're walking around town, for example, or just going home and greeting your neighbors, it's pretty safe to assume they're extras, or if you're walking around town, you can pretty much assume there's 99% of people are just playing their game and playing their part. And making it look good so the stage is perfect. And these are usually all extras. You can assume that. So I also find the film Truman exciting in this context. Oh yeah, that's right, we talked about that too. Exactly. And when the Truman film came out, people who had problems with dissociation actually went to a psychologist and claimed that the Truman film had triggered it. Oh, that reminds me of the series we watched, where she always went to the psychologist who got the pill, so they wouldn't discover their super abilities and remember who they really are. Yes, exactly right. Just like Truman. Yes. And it was the same with Truman. Truman was the only one in a simulated environment, in a simulated village or town that he lived in. And he was the only one born in this town. And he had no idea that this was actually just a giant commercial advertising installation. And anyone who wanted to could go into this city and advertise themselves. Because the Truman was so popular that the whole world watched him. All over the TVs. The whole world incredibly enjoyed watching Truman. A bit like Big Brother back then. And of course a lot of companies thought, oh, everyone is watching Truman, so we have to put our advertising in there. And then there were always gags like, hey Truman, have you tried the new cornflakes yet? And then they always held it up to the camera and stuff like that. And stories like that. And that's a great analogy. Yes, absolutely, yes. Because we once made a video about this intergalactic trade, that the aliens like our beer or clothes. Who knows? Whether those up there aren't all extras watching. And then here is our new beer. I mean, there are enough beer gardens and cafes and restaurants where they serve beer everywhere. Yes, or when you go to the restaurants. Yeah, look, today that's on our menu of the day and here's the latest beer and best wine. Yes. So a great analogy of the film Truman. If you haven't seen it yet, you should definitely check it out. But we think most of you already know the movie. And would be sad if not. Yes, great. So those are just a few tips that we can give. Look at some of that about the holodeck in Star Trek. How it's used there. And maybe Truman again. So these are really hints, intuitive inspirations for the screenwriters and film directors who are just trying to reproduce what is just part of our real reality. And this real reality or true reality can only be perceived in dissociation. We talked about the fact that the whole world is naturally kept in discord, and of course that goes well with all the extras, because of course the real people, can't really find each other, unite and work together. Well, who knows, if they aren't at odds with each other, because they're programmed that way in the course of life and have adopted all the patterns, whatever. But precisely because of this whole division that you find again and again in society as a whole. Of course you can't come together, stick together and overthrow the system. How is that possible? Of course, that's correct. There's another interesting question. Who programs the extras? Perhaps there are some of you who deal with extras on a daily basis. We're going to assume that very strongly. And if you've ever wondered why they behave this way and that is completely at odds with how you would normally act. So stories like that. But of course we don't want you to jump at people and say, you're an extra, you're just pretending. And unfortunately we all act as if, only they know that, we know it too. Anyway, the whole thing is pretty scary considering you're walking through the city and 99% are extras, so not really real. And then you can suddenly feel pretty lonely when no one is there for real. In any case, we like to do it in the cafe and 10, 20, 30 minutes is enough. Sometimes you don't even want to stop. And it's really, really exciting. And once you're inside, you slow down so much that you can't really get out. Even if you go out, you're still partially inside. So cafes are just perfect for that, because there is always something going on. The mind is already distracted by it anyway. You get to think less. Yes, well, we are already very trained in it anyway. That simplifies things even more. When you're in the cafe and you're distracted by the music, all your senses are actually busy. That's the best way to say it. The senses are busy. You don't even get to think. You're just observing and then at some point you automatically get into the dissociative state. That's why we can recommend public places like cafes and restaurants. Yes, restaurants aren't quite as ideal, because the waiter comes all the time. But in a cafe, we also like to sit there and work for hours, 4, 5, 6 hours, then the waiter doesn't come that often and then you have your time to dissociate. Cafe is very good. After the waiter has taken care of you, you can practice this very well and you can quickly get into the situation that somehow you suddenly feel like a bell is forming around you. And then suddenly, somehow you have the feeling, like this, first feelings come up, then such shallow feelings that you don't really feel so much at the beginning. So very shallow feelings, you could say half consciously, that then come up and then somehow you get the impression that something is wrong here. Exactly, one becomes suspicious at first. Yes, you get a little suspicious at first and think something isn't going the way it should and be paranoid. So when you leave at some point, you're pretty paranoid. Yes, but a positive paranoia. So not that you stand there like that. No way. It's very exciting. Yes. Well, it's important that you also learn dissociation. To use the feelings that come up as advice and not to fall into some kind of delusion. Even when paranoid feelings arise, she tries to use them constructively. Use the constructive paranoia now, I say, because actually it's all just a message from within, which tries to express itself through distrust, a slight feeling of distrust. I find it exciting when you are in a state of distrust and paranoia that it actually promotes the state of dissociation. You can then go deeper into it if you keep the feeling going. Yes, but as I said, we're not talking about strong, paranoid states or anything like that, but about constructive application, about a shallow paranoia, about a shallow distrust that just helps you to look behind the scenes of the matrix. And please do so as an observer. Try to be sober about the perception you are getting. Gathers information. And observe in the state of dissociation, because then you can prove to yourself how it really is. Exactly. And when you suddenly get to a point where your mind tells you, oh, I still have to do something. Oh, I'm not in the mood to continue at this point, because then you have crossed a threshold. Yes. Just badass. I don't care, say I'll move on now. Don't get distracted at this point. You're quite welcome to do so. Oh, I gotta check what messages I got on Facebook or something. Yes, even small things. I have to get my coffee up and take a sip of coffee or something. Not at all, just That's right. As soon as the mind comes up with something like that, do it now, then you'll slowly come to this threshold, where it suddenly becomes effective or efficient, where the dissociation and the energy released as a result can suddenly also have an effect. But I think dissociation is exciting and we're doing the next workshop about it. Online seminar. Yeah, the advertising woman specialist, exactly. At our next place of residence, we will work hard to ensure that it comes online in the next month or two. That's right. We're doing a nice online seminar on this with techniques, tips, things you don't know yet and I'm excited. Practical application. Yes. That's the way, and then the book and the online seminar is of course a perfect combination. No, we don't want to sell it. But it really is the best thing out there just for expanding your consciousness. Therefore, we cannot stress this enough. Yes, can you think of anything else about the hosts and sharers? Yes, we had talked about a lot, but I think the video is really very long again, and we gave impulses and input. And I think our viewers can now go into a dissociative state themselves and find out if it's true. Yes, right, train the dissociation, then you can look it up yourself. And don't put so much pressure on yourself. I can't do it, I get a thought every 10 seconds, it's okay. Of course, we also have a thought every now and then at the beginning, until we completely lose it. So don't stress. If you don't think for 10 times 10 seconds, then you have already stored energy. Of course you're not deep in it then, but it's a slightly dissociative state. So don't worry. Don't have such high expectations. Don't put yourself under pressure. Then it will work out on its own anyway. Let the music distract you a bit and the conversations and what you see in the cafe or outside. And then you don't worry. Yes, at the end there is now a little story. Jonathan had a dream, which of course he wrote down on the Matrix blog about the hosts and Yes, yes. Well, recently I also had a dream. I was sitting at a big table with about 10 people or so, and three women were sitting across from me, and one woman said to me, Jonathan, look at these two women, and I was like, yes, okay, and said to me, it's hosted and it's shared. Is it like that, huh? What does it want from me? How is it hosted and is it shared? And then somehow at that moment I started looking at the women, and they both looked normal. And there was no difference somehow. They looked different optically and were definitely different in character, but there was nothing different on the outside. There wasn't a note on their ear now saying I'm hosted and I'm shared or anything, nothing. And I found that very interesting at that moment. The statement and from the dream we also have the terms host and sharer. We have always used the terms extras and guard and point. And of course those who have just taken over a body, the gods, the creator beings. And I found it very interesting that the woman dealt with these terms in the dream as if they were completely normal and familiar, at least where they came from. Yes, yes, it's hosted and it's shared. Yes, we know it's always like that. Yes, and that's where the terms hosts and sharers come from. And yes, the term host also appears in the film. In the series. No, nonsense, Westworld. In Westworld, yes, exactly, we talked a lot about that too. Yes, that was also very, very, it's presented a little differently there. Yes, very, so if you don't know the series, definitely watch it. Yeah, yes, it just turns around. The hosts are the ones who have amnesia and have no perspective and are then, so to speak, symbolic of people in their virtual or artificially created environment. Yes. Well, then slowly develop an awareness and become aware. And it definitely looks right. Yes, I think that's it for today, right? We are very happy that you watched again. And of course, we look forward to your comments. Perhaps you have had similar experiences. Exactly. Or some of you know dissociation and thought and perceived something similar. We would be very happy if you wrote something about it below. Exactly. And maybe we'll be able to do live streams again next Sunday. We don't want to promise it, but maybe it will work. Let how the internet is. Maybe not this Sunday, but after. Yes, exactly. Yes, then we wish you a nice evening. And take care. Until next time, bye.